Okay, so good afternoon, dear students. So in the last class, we were discussing about the that is data pre-processing techniques. So in that, we have completed total four techniques till now. Okay, so first one is aggregation, second one is sampling, third one is dimensionality reduction, and fourth one is feature subset selection. In that, we have seen the architecture of feature subset selection in the last class. Okay, so this feature subset selection, see, it is used to select only a subset of features from the available features so that we can efficiently perform the data mining algorithms. Okay, so in that, see, we had selected some of the features based on some of the criterias or some search strategy. Okay, so we have got one more that is the technique for selecting a subset of features, so that is feature weighting. Okay, so feature weighting, see, it is also one kind of a technique. Okay, it is an alternative for selecting or choosing some of the subset of features. Okay, so in feature weighting, see, what we will be doing is we will be assigning the weights to the features here. So based on the weights, we will be choosing only important features here. The features which have got the more weight will be chosen as the important features, and we will leave the features which has got the lower weight. Okay, so that we can select only a subset of features. So in case of feature weighting, say weights will be assigned to the features here. Okay, and they will be assigned with the higher weight if they are very important features, and if they are less important features, they will be assigned a lower. Okay, so based on the weights here, we will be choosing a subset of features. Okay, so now the thing is, who is going to assign the weights? Okay, so we common people, we can't assign the weights to the features here. See, the domain experts or the knowledge workers, see, based on their domain knowledge, they will be assigning the weights to the features here so that they can make a distinction between the important features and the less important features. Okay, or else, see, even system can also be used to determine the weights of the features automatically. So feature weighting, so it is one of the alternative techniques for choosing the subset of features here. Okay, so more important features will be assigned higher weights here, and less important features will be assigned lower weights. Okay, so and these weights, they will be assigned by the domain experts here, which are having domain knowledge. Okay, so and also some of the systems, see, even they can also assign the weights to the features automatically. Okay, so this is about the feature weighting. Okay, so now coming to the next thing, that is next technique. So that is a pre-processing technique, fifth technique it is, that is feature creation. Okay, so as the name says here, that is feature creation. So in case of feature creation technique, say we'll be creating the new features. Okay, original features you will be used here in order to create the new features. Okay, so new set of features will be created here using the original attributes of the features here. So it is one of the frequently used technique here, which is used to create from the original attributes a new set of attributes. Okay, so new attributes will be created here, or new features will be created using the original attributes. Okay, so and these new features which you have created, they will be having, or they will be capturing the important information which is present in the data set. See, in the original data, say some of the important features or the information will not be present. Suppose if you create a new set of features using the existing attributes of the features, then it will be conveying or capturing the important information very effectively. Okay, and these new set of features, see, they will be smaller in number compared to the original set of attributes. See, if you have got less number of attributes, see, as you know, in case of dimensionality reduction, see, where we will be reducing the number of attributes or the features so that we can get many of the advantages there, like processing time is going to reduce, and it will be consuming a less amount of time for processing, and less amount of memory will be required, and we can create a new kinds of models using the less dimensions. See, all those advantages even we can get with the help of feature creation also. So feature creation, it will be creating a new set of attributes here, and these new sets of attributes will be having some of the features which are not even present in the original data. See, original data, it will be lacking some of the features. see those new features which we have created will be very helpful so that we can use them to apply some of the new data mining algorithms. Okay, so here for creating the new features, see, we have got three different methods here. So I'll explain them here. So see here. So first method is feature extraction. Okay, so feature extraction, it is one of the method or the technique that is used to create the new sets of features. Okay, so in case of feature extraction, say we will be creating the new sets of features from the original raw data. Okay, so again, definition is same here. Creation of the new set of features from the original data, see, it is called as feature extraction. So creation of the new set of features from the original raw data, that is called as a feature extraction. The feature creation is nothing but that is creating the new sets of features, and these new sets of features, they will be created from the original raw data. Okay, so that is called as a feature extraction. Okay, so now coming to the example. So see here, see, in case of a photograph, see, you want to classify whether that photograph contains a human face or not. Okay, so I want to that is classify in a photograph whether there is a human face or not. Okay, so now you know that, see how the photograph raw data will be displayed. See, it will be displayed in the form of pixels. Okay, and these pixels information, see, it will not be understandable by the classification algorithm, because here I am performing the classification task whether that photograph is containing the human face or not. So for that human classification task, see, I am considering the data set here. That data set contains the pixels here, and this pixel information data is not understandable to the classification algorithm. So what I need to do is, see, I need to produce or create the new sets of features, higher level features here, using these pixels. Okay, so those higher level features, they will be conveying some that is edges and areas. Even you might have seen, see, the pictures that contain the human faces, they will be having some kinds of edges. So based on that, we can classify whether the photograph has got the that is human face or not. Okay, so here, see, the raw data, it has been converted, okay, into high level features that contains the human faces, edges and the areas. So based on that, we can easily classify whether this photograph contains a human face or not. That is, we have created a new set of features, that is edges and the areas, using the existing set of features. Okay, so existing set of features is that is availability of the pixels here. Okay, so this is one of the example for feature extraction. Okay, and this feature extraction technique, so it is highly domain specific. Domain specific means, say, for example, say if you have got the data mining techniques here, which are applicable to data mining algorithms. Feature extraction techniques, they can be used only by the that is data mining algorithm. So you can't use those techniques in the image processing algorithms. So it is domain specific. See, for which that is domain you have developed the technique, it has to be used in that only domain. Okay, you can't use those techniques in the other domains like image processing or machine learning or deep learning, like that. So if you are having some of the techniques here for feature extraction, okay, so they have to be used only for that domain. So if you are having a data mining techniques here for feature extraction, then it has to be used only for the data mining algorithms. You can't use that for image processing. Okay, so it is highly domain specific here. And see, one more thing is, see, this that is data mining, see, it is also applied to new areas. Okay, so even it is used for knowledge extraction in the e-commerce sites also, and new kinds of techniques have been developed for feature extraction in data mining. But remember that, see, this is a domain specific that is technique. You can't use that in other fields. Okay, so this is the first technique. Okay, so now second technique is, that is the mapping data to the new space. Okay, see, we will be converting the data which is present in one view into a completely different that is view that will be conveying you very important features. Okay, so you'll be having the data in one view or space, that data will be converted into another space. Okay, so that is called as mapping the data to a new space. It is just like See, you are converting the data from one form to another form. Okay. So that new form, see, it will be conveying you more important features. So that is called as mapping the data to new space. So it is also one kind of feature construction technique. So in mapping the data to a new space, say we will be mapping the data, okay, so which is in one form or the view to a completely different view or a form, so that new view, it will be conveying a very important and interesting features here. So that is called as mapping here. So for example, see, I had explained about the time series data. So time series data is nothing but your sine form data. Okay, so I had given one example, that is measurement of temperature over time. Okay, so it will be shown in a form of waves. Okay, so that is measurement of temperature at different times. Okay, so that kind of data is time series data. Okay, suppose, see, if you are finding any patterns here, okay, so if you got only one kind of pattern and there is no much noise in that time series data, then you can easily find that pattern. If that time series data is very clear without any noise, okay, so then you can easily find the pattern if you have got to find only one pattern. Okay. Suppose if you are if you want to find a more number of patterns, okay, and data, time series data, see, if it contains more amount of noise, see, then you will not be able to find the pattern. Okay, so then what I need to do is, see, I need to convert this time series data into another format, or another format of time series, by applying Fourier transforms. So you might have studied this technique in the mathematics. Say Fourier transformation technique. So I can apply that to time series data, and I can map the data to a new space. Okay, so that I can easily find the patterns. So this is one of the examples. So in case of mapping the data to a new space, say we will be mapping the data which is present in one view into a new space. That is conversion. That is, we are converting the data from one form to another form here, so that we can find the interesting and the important features here. So one of the example is, that is time series data. So in case of time series data, see, what we will be doing is, see, we will be finding some of the patterns which are present in this data. So periodic patterns we want to find. Suppose if the data is very clear, if it doesn't contain any noise, and if you want to find only one kind of a pattern here, then that can be done very easily here, because the data doesn't contain any of the pattern. Noise. Suppose if the data contains a large quantity of noise, and if you want to find a more number of patterns in that data, so what I need to do is, I need to convert this time series data into a form so that I can find the patterns here. So in order to map that data to a new form or a new space, so we'll be using one technique that is called as Fourier transformation. So it will map the data, time series data, to a new space from where you can easily find the periodic pattern. So this is the second technique that is applied for, that is feature construction. Okay, so that is creation. Okay, and third technique in the feature, that is creation, is feature construction. Okay. See, in case of feature construction, see, there will be some of the features, okay, in the original data. Okay, so those features, see, they will not be in a form that can be easily applied to data mining algorithm. So for data mining algorithm, you will be requiring the features in some suitable form. Okay, but in the existing data, in the original data, you are having those features, but they are not in the form which can be used in the data mining algorithm. Okay, so what I need to do is, see, I need to construct one or more new features using these original features. Okay, so that those new features, they can be useful for data mining algorithm. That is called as feature construction. So in case of feature construction, see, we will be creating a new set of features here using the existing original features, so that they can be used in the data mining algorithm. That is called as feature construction. So feature construction is one of the method that is used in the feature creation. See here, original data, see, it contains some of the features, but those features are not in a form so that they can be used with the data mining algorithm. they are not in a suitable form. So what I need to do, I need to convert them into a form that is required by the data mining algorithm. So for that conversion, say we will be using the technique that is called as feature construction. So in the feature construction, we will be constructing one or more features here using the original features. Okay, so that is called as feature construction. Example is, see, for example, let us consider that you have got the information about the historical artifacts. So you have got the information about the monuments, historical monuments. So you want to classify those monuments. Okay, so that is with which material they are made up of. Okay, so based on the type of material, I want to classify these artifacts here. So artifacts are old buildings. I can give you an example, that is old buildings like Taj Mahal. Okay, so then you have got many different kinds of monuments. Okay, so all those can be called as artifacts here. So I want to classify these historical artifacts based on the type of material which they are made up of. Okay, so let us consider that I have got the data here, data set of the historical artifacts, but this data set contains the information like volume and the mass. Okay, so volume and the mass, that is the information that is present in the data set. Okay, but based on this information, that is volume and mass, I can't classify the artifacts, okay, to which based on which material they are made up of. Okay, so material information I can't get using this, that is mass and volume. So what I need to do is, say, I need to construct one more feature that is called as a density. We know that density is equal to mass by volume. So I will construct a new feature, that is density. So that is equal to mass by volume. So based on the density of the, that is material, so I can easily classify the monuments or the artifacts. That is, we have created a new feature, or we have constructed a new feature out of the existing features here, original features. That is, mass and volume is given in the data set, but I can't use that information in order to classify the monuments based on the type of material. So what I need to do, I need to construct a new feature here, that is density, using this mass and volume, so that now I can easily classify the artifacts based on the type of material. So this is about the third technique. Okay, so this is about the feature creation. Okay, so that is a pre-processing technique. Okay, so next topic, so better I will discuss in the next class, because if I continue now, say half of the topic will be covered and it will be confusing. So better I will start the next topic in the next class. Okay, just wait for some time, I will take your attendance.